Dear IIF community, dear friends and colleagues, I am particularly honored to be addressing you as the incoming president of the International Astronautical Federation, the IIF. Through the able leadership of previous presidents and vice presidents, and the work of the enthusiastic volunteer community over the years, IIF has developed into the world's leading space advocacy body with over 300 members organizations, including all leading space agencies, companies, societies, associations, universities, and institutes across 66 countries. The International Astronautical Congress, the IASC, our annual premium event, has become the international recognized gathering of the global space community and a must-attend event for all space actors within this unique network. And through its series of global conferences initiated in 2010, focusing on topics such as exploration, applications, and innovation, the IIF has extended its portfolio of conventions. Now, taking over the presidency of the IIF, it is my firm intention and my obligation, together with the experienced team of vice presidents, to guarantee its further development and ready it for the global challenges which are ahead of us. To that end, with my colleagues, we have established an IIF Global Innovation Agenda 2016-2019 based on the following principles. First, preserving our heritage and building on existing trends. Second, listening and opening up to the world. And third, preparing the future and connecting all space people. In implementing this agenda during my presidency, we shall focus on a total of 7 concrete priority actions. First, reaching out to emerging countries and connecting with new communities. Our main goals here are to get emerging countries more closely involved in IIF activities, to attract new communities like internet companies, and to produce benefits for these communities and countries. Second, we want to foster the principle of 3G diversity, 3G for geography, generation, and gender within the IIF and the space sector in general. And I can tell you that it is my aim to make the IIF an exemplary organization in terms of geographical, generational, gender, and any other diversity aspects, and to live up to our motto, connecting all space people. To that end, an IIF 3G international platform for diversity and equality in astronautics, or IIF 3G ID for short, shall be created to enable us to take a leading role in the effort to promote and advance diversity and equality across the global space community. Third point, we want to focus on the evolution of the IASC with a view to achieving sustainability and, of course, future growth. As the organizational and logistical challenges facing the IIF and its partners are steadily increasing with the rising expectations of Congress participants and the continuously growing program, it is time to review the manifold aspects of organizing the Congress in its present form and to look at how it might evolve in the years ahead. Fourth point, we have to organize global and regional conferences, and in fact, we have to continue to organize them. Under my leadership, of course, we will continue this series of conferences, and we will review our strategy in terms of purpose and rationale, selection process, and mid- and long-term planning. Global and regional conferences shall become an integral part of the IIF offered to its members and the global space community in response to specific needs and interests. Fifth objective, fostering relations and interaction with our partner organizations. Putting the fruitful interactions with partner organizations like the III, IISL, COSPAR, UNOSA, ITU, UNESCO, and others on solid ground and achieving sustainable and mutually beneficial cooperation, we will undertake a dedicated effort to identify synergies and common goals and, where appropriate, establish formal agreement regulating partners' interaction and cooperation. Sixth point, evolving the IAF funding structure, because of course we need to have balanced accounts. We shall investigate ways of making the IAF funding structure less dependable on the rather volatile financial result of the annual IACs, and further diversify income streams by considering our alliance program, sponsorship activities, publications, and the financial results of global and regional conferences. Last but not least, the seventh point, leading the IAF towards the future with innovative projects. Continuing our efforts to permanently develop new activities and provide additional offers and services to our members, we shall implement new initiatives like the Digital Paper Archive System, which is a platform for members to meet and exchange outside the framework on IAC, an IAF app, and many more besides. In total, I sincerely believe that all these actions will enable the IAF to remain the leading global space association and to further extend its reach, influence, and impact on the successful and peaceful development of space for the benefit of humanity. With the support of our bureau colleagues, all the volunteers active in our IAF committees and the IAF secretariat, I am convinced that we will be able to jointly achieve our goals and pursue the IAF success story. It is my clear commitment as President of CNES, as co-chair of the Council of ISA, and as an active member of the IAA to lead the IAF as its president for the coming 3 years with the utmost dedication and confidence in the full backing of the IAF community. I want to tell you that the IAF will continue its mission to connect all space people. I look forward to working with all of you, and while I don't propose to take you to the moon of Mars, it certainly is my intention that we should reach for the stars.